Down with the rebound. ETSU wants to run. Bo Hodges going all the way inside, dumps it off, and an easy lay-in there for Jerome Rodriguez.
Nearly creates the turnover. ETSU able to break the press. Tisdale with a left-handed three. Another offensive rebound. A putback for Hughley. Got earlier this week. Out of the break. Shot clock. Inside three. Hughley had to reset. Lets the three fly and knocks it.
New role was running the team. He's thinking too much about pass and other situations as we see. Very active. LSU challenging everything.
Rylan Gasson after 11 straight misses. ETSU just getting it done on the offensive glass. And one. What a strong move there by Bo Hodges. Chance for a three-point. Hodges kicks it out. Good. Lets it fly. And he's got a three. And ETSU is back within one. Tipped around. And the Buccaneers come away with it. Good, gonna try another one. This time in transition, rattles home the three.
Good, 6 foot.
Boyd guarded by Bays, trying to find some space. Good, can it be three in a row? Yes, it is. He missed his first three. He has made his last three from deep. The answer, offensive rebound. A defensive rebound for Damian Williams. Maybe the shortest guy on the court. Tries to go coast to coast and lays it in with the left hand. Another three, this time.
From the offensive team, helps the defensive team.
Rodriguez gets the roll.
Give them any kind of attention whatsoever.
Game clock down to five, shot clock off. Trey Boyd, tough shot, draws the foul.
Opportunities at times, he caught the ball, no hesitation, made a right dish to Williams.
Ooh, but Bo Hodges with the explosion, all the way
getting to the ball.
And the block inside by Williams. Good, gets a little bit of space. Mid-range jumper, rattles it home. Come into the game for Gasson, went to the bench after picking up his first foul.
Now you see that right there? See how he caught the ball? Just don't have time to do all that dribbling in the middle of the high post. The defense is eventually going to come and get you.
Back to LSU. Minus 17. They trail in this game by 13. Make it 16. It's gracious. Exactly. That's what ETSU wanted to do.
Yeah.
They wanted it to be ugly.
Yep. They flipped the script.
But they look smooth and confident.
It's going to be difficult.
Forbes today about the anatomy of an upset. When you go on the road like this, no.
You get it back again.
Now Hodges,
eventually you're going to score. It's trusting their offense, getting the ball. That's a credit to ETSU. Oh my God, hello.
A 20-point lead, the biggest advantage of the night for ETSU.
That was sweet right there.
Williams, free throw line extended, just a rainbow that he drops in.
Again, when you're up under control, makes a nice bounce pass away from the defense for the score.
Good, off the one dribble.
Which turns into a basket. Get back with
that did everything but go down, but a 19th offensive rebound. And coaches have already gone to half court. ETSU just going to dribble it out as this clock winds up down. And ETSU goes to 10-2 on the year. They come into Baton Rouge, and they pull the upset.
Basketball Live. We'll check in on the game of the night that was played in Johnson City, Tennessee. We're going to chat with one of the most underrated coaches in the country next. The center of the college basketball world Wednesday was Johnson City, Tennessee. SoCon lead on the line between East Tennessee State and Furman. According to Joe Lenardi, the loser would drop out of the field. Trey Boyd and the Bucks were balling, Sean.
They were, and this East Tennessee State team, I mean, made a splash in the non-conference by going down to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and absolutely destroying LSU. And tonight, they were good, really good. And Patrick Good from the outside, he's feeling it. And a big night for him, a big night for East Tennessee State to get back on top inside the SoCon. Remember, Joe Lunardi had them as an at-large team because of how good their resume is.
Joe, how exactly after this win tonight does the committee view the Bucks' resume right now?
Oh, it doesn't matter as much because now they're the AQ from the Southern Conference. Maybe an 11 seed. We'll see how high they can go.
For three. Yes, he is. And yes, he did. Yes, he did. And yes, he did. Pat Good wants another three. Pat Good's got another three. Over to Good. Wide open. Another three. And he got another. He is incredible right now. Good open again. Good. Got another one. Oh, Pat Good. 23. Now Slaughter. Hodges. Dry. Shot off the glass. Good. Buxley. First time. It's early first half. Timeout. The Bucks. Back to Good. Good. Pull up trigger for a three. He got it with 6.8. Can you top this? Pat Good. Another three. 26 points on seven.
To control tempo.
Mike Morgan, Mark Wise in front of another
crowd. Their respective schools. ETSU in white, Wofford in black. First three ball is on the way.
Field goal percentage defense, second best in the SoCon.
Work it out to the wing. It's Boyd on a three. He's got the green light and he delivers on the triple. This program around a short amount of time. Pull-up jumper from 15, can't find it. Rebound fought for, and that's the biggest concern for Wofford. Needing to get going. Three ball from the wing. Wow, Buccaneers absolutely on.
That you would come in on a seven-game losing streak and play as well as they have played.
Open the heart for Joe Hughley, the senior.
When you ask both coaches about that first game, they gave the same answer. Ugly.
Ugly.
49-48.
Oh.
Really impressed with Wofford's transition defense. They are making ETSU off the ball better because they're not getting through screens, and there's a great example on cue.
Williamson with the steal, Boyd with the floater. Buccaneers having a hard time finding an open look. That's another tough shot, but that time Trey Boyd was smooth on that turnaround shot. Hodges. A little bit too much mustard on that pass. They work it around. Open three on the way. Beautiful off the curl, off the screen. Storm Murphy drills the three, and we're tied again at 29. Three on the way, a response by Isaiah Tisdale to do more things and play many, many more minutes. Great take to the second half.
Better body movement, better ball movement.
Better look at the rim for another team to start this second half. That will work. And a stuff right on top of the head of Goodwin.
All the way forward, it got through Goodwin. Oh, right on it.
Inside, again, giving up size. No whistle.
Right, seven-footer with the quick hands.
See the resume for ETSU as Kassan gets it done on the other end. Conference hit the 30-win plateau. Off the inbounds, beautiful play. 15 points for the junior out of Blythewood, South Carolina. Three on the other end. There's a response by Tisdale. His first points in the second half.
Warriors team, the strength that he's had being a part of this Wofford group. He said that he feels like
able to go pro after last year before the foot injury kept him from doing so. Rodriguez goes to what a move by the big man.
BYU is most certainly in, and St. Mary's is likely in. I think BYU is going to be a tough matchup.
Buccaneers are going to take home their ninth Southern Conference Tournament crown. 72-58, your final score. Celebration here in Asheville and back in Johnson City, Tennessee.